When it comes to issues of pleasure, we prefer both and. We don't like either or. The more ways we can find pleasure, the more types of pleasure we can find, the better. Because after all, that's a lot of what pleasure is about, is the variety. And we don't like the idea that we would have to be stuck on one particular type of pleasure, or that we have to abandon some of the things we already like for the sake of something we also like. We want to have it all. As the Buddha once said, that even if it rained gold coins, we wouldn't have enough for people's sensual pleasures, sensual desires. We always want more and more. And we tend to be pretty stupid about the issue of pleasure. Psychologists who've looked into the matter have shown that many times people know the drawbacks of a certain activity, and yet they still go back to it again and again and again, even when they know they have better things to do, more lasting, more solid forms of pleasure. There's some that they just really are attached to. So it's not the case when you find a better pleasure that your attachments to your old pleasures just fall away like leaves off a tree. There's a tendency in the mind to just keep wanting more and more of the stuff we've already had a good experience someplace with. And you see this even among some of the noble ones, stream enterers. The Buddha has to counsel them to be heedful. That was his last instruction. All the monks gathered at the Buddha's passing away, the least advanced, were stream enterers. And still the Buddha had to counsel them to be heedful. And there are other places in the canon where he points out that even a stream enterer can be heedless. After all, there's a sense that, okay, you know there's a deathless. There's a sense of security that comes from that. You only have, at most, 7 more lifetimes, and they're all going to be human lifetimes. And it's possible for a stream enterer to become complacent, to say nothing of people who've experienced jhana, or right concentration. Just the fact that you have a really refined pleasure in right concentration doesn't mean that you automatically let go of your attachments to other things, other forms of pleasure. Again, the principle of both and applies here. People want to enjoy their concentration and all the other pleasures they've managed to gather up in the course of their lives. This is why we also need discernment, to point out that there are a lot of areas where it's either or, and particularly to see the drawbacks of a lot of the old pleasures that we've been wallowing in. One, we don't like to be told that we've been engaging in harmful or unskillful behavior. And secondly, the mind has an incredible tendency to put up walls, to screen out the negative sides of our pleasures. Because after all, we like our pleasures so much, we don't acknowledge the fact that they have their drawbacks. I was talking to a monk recently who had been to the morgue, the police morgue in Bangkok, where they allow monks to come and observe autopsies. And he saw the doctors working in the morgue very efficiently, going through bodies, opening them up, all the guts and stuff spilling out. And he said he wondered, how is it that they managed to go home and sleep with their wives, still enjoy their old sensual pleasures? And he walked into their office, and there were girly calendars all over the walls. In other words, they were determined to maintain that perception, the perception of the beauty of the body, in spite of what they were seeing every day. And there's that side of the mind that wants to maintain its old attachments. It doesn't give them up easily. Give things up only when you really see that there's a direct connection between suffering and the pleasure that you've enjoyed. That's when the mind really lets go. And this is the duty of discernment, to see the drawbacks of these things. This is why right concentration on its own or jhana on its own, is not enough to cut through your other attachments. Because simply the fact that you can sit here and be very blissful, very equanimous, doesn't mean on its own that you're going to see the connections between unskillful pleasures and their negative side. That requires an act of determination. You really have to be heedful to remind yourself it's either or. You have to work at developing this strength of discernment. I mentioned this morning that passage in Ajahn Chah, where he talks about knowledge of the three characteristics. Not as a truth, not as a form of discernment. He says this strength. He refers to the knowledge as a strength. And that's what it is. It gives you a place to step back from your attachments, where you can stand outside them and really look at them. Because for the most part, we just jump into our attachments, jump into our pleasures, and totally lose perspective. And because they slosh around, we get sloshed around as well. But being able to step back from them gives us a good solid place to stand. And it's that solid place to stand, that's a strength in the mind. It helps us to resist the temptation to go jumping back in. So it's a theme you have to contemplate over and over again, the theme of either or, together with the theme of seeing the connections between the pleasures you enjoy and the drawbacks that they carry in their wake. This is why the path has right view right at the very beginning, and why the Buddha said of all the various strengths in the mind, it's strength of discernment that holds all the other ones together. The image he gives is of a house. You're building a house, and the various boards and posts and other parts of the house, the parts of the walls, the parts of the roof, it's that board across the top of the roof. That's what, once that's in place, then everything else gets held together. Up to that point, they can still sway back and forth. They're still not quite solid, but it's when you finally get that ridge pole up across the top that everything fits together properly and stays solid. The ridge pole is discernment, wisdom. Up until that point, everything can sway back and forth. You can like your concentration, but you can also like whatever else life has to offer. It's like a big flower garden or a big buffet. You can choose all the things you want. That's the attitude we'd like to have. It's only when you clearly see that it's either or. The more you let your mind go wandering around in sensual desires, the harder it is to get back. The harder it is to turn the concentration into something even more transcendent. Even when you've hit the transcendent for the first time, you're still not totally safe. Again, as I mentioned, there can still possibly be some complacency, where this is good enough. You've reached that point of being a noble one for sure, guaranteed against falling into the lower realms, guaranteed that nirvana will be attained within 7 lifetimes. So it is possible to be complacent, even on that level. So while we practice, we need to have this added strength, the strength of discernment, that on the one hand helps us see connections, and also see where there's a disconnect, where you have to choose one form of pleasure over another. It's that passage in the Dhammapada that when you see a greater form of happiness that comes from abandoning a lesser form of happiness, you will. The wise person abandons the lesser form for the sake of the greater. No, it's only the wise person who does that. Someone who once translated this verse and said, this couldn't possibly be the meaning. It is so obvious. Everyone does this. Well, no, very few people do this. Very few people see that it's an either-or. They want the both and. It's because we're so stupid around pleasure. Sometimes we intentionally make ourselves stupid. We don't want to see the connection between our pleasures and their drawbacks. We don't want to see the way one pleasure fights with another, is inconsistent with another. So it is important that we develop concentration, but you want to develop the discernment that makes it right concentration, that keeps it on track and helps you to appreciate it for what it is. It's one of those rare pleasures that has no drawbacks. It may be shaky in the beginning, and that's one of the reasons why we don't want to put all our hope in it, because we know how difficult it is to attain. And the later on, when it becomes easier and more consistent, then we can get complacent about that, too. Think, well, we can get it into it whenever we want. So you have to develop the discernment, the strength in the mind that can help overcome both forms of complacency, both attitudes that make you want to have a both and. As long as you're still on the path, that either or has to be kept in mind. Or it's only the wisdom of either or that you can get beyond.